School Freeware's QBasic tutorial series, Tutorial 1, Getting Started. This is a remake of the original QBasic tutorial series. QBasic 1.1 and QB64 is used within this tutorial series. The series is compatible with QBasic 1.1 and QB64 unless otherwise noted. All code can be downloaded for free at schoolfreeware.com. QBasic is a simple to learn and teach computer language. It is excellent for showing programming logic, and can be made to work on Windows, Mac, and Linux. And the skills learned with QBasic can be modified for Visual Basic programming. For those running Windows XP and older versions of Windows, you can use QBasic 1.1 running natively. QBasic 1.1 is a free download at the website listed on the screen. For those running 32-bit Windows Vista, Windows 7, and Mac 10, you can run QBasic 1.1 within DOSBox. DOSBox is a free DOS program that is available at DOSBox.com. For those running 64-bit Windows, Mac, and Linux, you can use QB64. QB64 is a free download at QB64.net. QB 1.1 has built-in help files, and for those using QB64, you can find the help files located at QB64.net wiki. Once again, all code can be downloaded at schoolfreeware.com. This tutorial will use QBasic 1.1 running in DOSBox on Windows 7 Service Pack 1 and QB64 running on Windows 7 Service Pack 1. If you're having difficulty saving your source code, you may need to change your Windows preferences or run the program from another location, such as your desktop or documents folder. I'll start this tutorial by using QBasic 1.1 within DOSBox. Here we have the IDE of QBasic 1.1, which includes the File menu, Edit menu, View, Search, Run, Debug, and Options. Here we have Help, and if I go into Index, I'll find all the keywords, functions, and commands that I can use within QBasic 1.1. So for example, I can scroll down, and I'll find our first command we're going to use, which is CLS, and I find that CLS clears the screen. And here's a few examples on how to use CLS. I'll click back on Index. Now let's go to another item. Here we have ABS function. I find that ABS returns the absolute value of a number. And here's a few examples on how to use the ABS. I'll hit Escape and go back to the IDE. So here, I'm just going to make a simple little program. I'll clear the screen, CLS, and I'll print within quotation, Hello from QBasic 1.1, end quotes, and I'll go ahead and run the first program. So I click on Run, then Start. The program prints what I told it to print. Press any key to continue. Now, if I wish to save, I'll go to File and Save. And within QBasic 1.1, you have up to 8 characters for the file name. The file extension will be .bas, which the computer will automatically add to your program. So it's very important not to go over 8 characters. So here I'll just put in QBT1 for tutorial 1. I'll click on OK. And here we have QBT1.bas automatically placed within our file name. If I go over 8 characters, then I could overwrite the file extension and then everything will be confused. Now, one of the problems of QBasic 1.1 is that the internal printing may not work for your system. Most likely, it won't work for your system, so I can't go to File and Print my source code. What I have to do is open up the folder where QBasic happens to be, and here I should have QB Tutorial 1, there it is, and then I can open it up with Notepad. So now I can go to File and Print the source code if I wish to do so. Go ahead and close down Notepad. For those using QBasic 1.1 within DOSBox on Macintosh, you need to use TextEdit instead of Notepad. Here is QB64. Once again, I'll just clear the screen and I'll print out Hello from QB64. And while I'm at it, I'll just go ahead and print. This is a second line of text. Once again, when you're printing out text or strings, use the quotation marks. So go ahead and run. Once again, I could go ahead and save, and this time I'll put in QB64 tutorial 1. Computer puts a file extension .bas. I'll just click on OK. Then within the QB64 folder, I should have QB64 tutorial 1. I can right mouse click on it, go to open with, I'll select notepad, click OK, and now I can go ahead and print the source code from notepad. I'll close notepad down, and I'll close the folder here. A major difference between QB64 and QBasic 1.1 is that QBasic 1.1 is an interpreter. It cannot make its own executable files. QB64 can make its own executable files by going to run and then make executable only.